Hello. In this video, we will review process of reconciling subledgers to the GL in Sage Intacct as a part of your ongoing month-end and year-end procedures. We will point out what we believe to be the most suitable set of reports for the subledger reconciliation. We will start with the GL trial balance, available on the GL, reports, bottom of the list. This report is not customizable, and it's go-to source of the true GL balances. Although it's highly recommended that you verify your GL balances via various balance sheet and profit and loss statements, since this report, GL trial balance, is not customizable, it eliminates any possible errors or omissions that can happen while designing other financial statements. To set parameters for trial balance, you can keep your reporting period as a current month, since trial balance provides opening balances for each account for the month. Cutoff date should be your period date that you're reconciling, period end date that you're reconciling, and you can also set up different filters here. On the format section, you can pick to print all accounts, all the accounts with activity, or do not show accounts with a zero activity. Also, you can include or exclude your statistical accounts or set up page orientation to be portrait and landscape. Once you define your options, define parameters, click on View. Usual features and options available for reports in Sage Intacct are to process and store report, email, or export in various formats. In this case, trial balance can be exported as Excel, CSV, or text file. Let's make a note of accounts receivable and retained receivable balances, as well as accounts payable and retained payable balances on a GL trial balance. We will compare those balances to the subledger reports. So let's run AP subledger report. First, we can duplicate our tab. Go to accounts payable. And our recommendation is to run under reports, vendor aging, report. Few things to notice on this screen. First of all, your cutoff date. Make sure it matches one that you use on your GL trial balance. Make sure that your based on section, which is your aged date selection, is set to GL posting date as opposed to bill date or due date. So this needs to be set to GL posting date. On the bottom, please make sure that you select report type, either detail or summary, but show vendors with zero balances needed for retainage to properly show, show fully paid bills with outstanding retainage, and select page orientation. So those two selections in the middle here are important for correct AP retainage section to print. Once you make your selections, click on View. Scroll to the bottom of the report, and let's make note of balances. To make this more visible, we can just split our tabs into two separate screens and compare them beside each other. So if you look at the GL trial balance for accounts payable, our current balance is $215,105.64, which matches our age report. And the same thing would be for our retainage balance, $137,08.45. So our accounts payable seem to be in a balance. Next, let's run AR subledger report. Again, let's duplicate a tab. Let's go to accounts receivable, customer aging report. Same idea. Make sure that your dates are matching. Select the GL posting date, and down on the bottom, select your show customers with zero balances to yes, show fully paid invoices with outstanding retainage to yes. Click View. Let's do the same thing. Let's split our tabs. Let's shrink one with a GL trial balance and compare balances between two reports. Our current receivable balance matches one on a subledger, our retainage balance matches as well. So our accounts receivable subledger, it's balanced as well. Besides reconciling AP and AR to the GL, it's also highly recommended that you reconcile your project cost, detail project cost subledger, to your cost of goods sold or work in progress accounts on your GL. For the purpose of that reconciliation, again, we can use a trial balance and observe accounts that are included in our project account groups mapping. So let's duplicate the tab again, and let's review projects, setup, standard cost code type, cost type catalog. This catalog, catalog of your cost types, standard cost types, is a place where project subledger, it's mapped to your GL. Observe those accounts and make sure that those accounts are included in your cost reconciliation between GL and a project subledger. Another recommendation is that we create a financial report, let's call it project trial balance, that will map project data on a cost type level back to the GL accounts mapped to those cost types. Those GL accounts can be either cost of goods sold or work in progress, depending how book your entries. Please search our YouTube channel for more information on how to create financial reports. So let's run project trial balance. Under my report section, financial reports, I have a report called project trial balance. Let's run it and let's use the same cutoff date as we did for our GL trial balance. So this report on each row provides a project number and the name, and across we have a cost types that map to GL accounts that need to be reconciled back to GL. So let's separate this report into its own tab. Let's shrink trial balance and let's compare results. Could be a little bit trickier than it looks like, so just be patient with those screens. Okay, so if you scroll down to a labor cost on a GL, the balance on a GL matches my balance on a project trial balance. Subcontract, match. Material, another match. And then we have a cost of sales other. We have a discrepancy of $5,000 even on this account. We'll get back to this account. Finally, we have a cost of sales overhead. That matches my cost of sales overhead on project trial balance. So let's look at this discrepancy between cost of sales other on a GL and a project trial balance. We can start troubleshooting this discrepancy by drilling down on a dollar value, total in this case. We can review general ledger report and try to identify amount of discrepancy. In this case, it's fairly obvious. There's a $5,000 on a bottom entry that was made through the GL journal directly. So there is a journal entry made directly to cost of goods sold account. So in Intacct, that could be okay because we know that project is dimension available in a GL, so we could make adjusting entry to project in a GL, but this one for some reason was not done correctly. So we can drill down on the value, go directly to that journal entry and review it. And here's the problem right there. The first line, obviously this was done for the purpose of opening balances. So the first line debits project by $5,000 and corresponding account $5,500. On a second line, the entry is reversed from the GL account without any reference to the project. So net impact on a GL from this entry is zero, while impact on a project is a debit of $5,000, hence the discrepancy. So this entry would need to be corrected before GL is brought back in a balance, subledger rather, is brought back in a balance with the GL. So this was a quick review on how to reconcile subledgers in a Sage Intacct. Thank you for watching.